everywhere. Hello everyone, and welcome to the tutorial of Everywhere. Everywhere is the feature that connects creators' digital outfits to all avatars and digital spaces. Creators can easily optimize outfits designed in Clo 3D and Marvelous Designer to suit digital spaces, such as games, metaverse, and entertainment through Everywhere. Through this tutorial, we will learn the process of utilizing Everywhere for fitting outfits, mesh optimization, rigging, UV packing, and texture baking. Getting started with Everywhere. Click on the icon in the top right corner to open the Everywhere. When you run the Everywhere, you will notice the window showing up on the top right corner of the 2D window. Furthermore, you can check the polygon count of both garments and avatars in the bottom left corner of the 3D window. Everywhere is structured with two major tabs, garments and materials. Within the garment tab, users can perform the polygon optimization and rigging. Meanwhile, the material tab offers features like UV packing, texture baking, and material. Polygon optimization. Considering the different mesh limits and capacities supported by each platform, it is crucial to optimize the poly count of the outfit according to the desired platform. You can achieve the optimization in the garment tab by modifying the polygon count for your target platform. The polygon count displayed on the right side of the garment in the Everywhere window indicates the current mesh count of the outfit, including buttons and accessories. To see the polygon count of the current avatar, simply navigate to the avatar located beneath the garment. Furthermore, you can check the polygon count of the patterns and trim at the bottom left of 3D window. To optimize the polygon count of the outfit, enter your target polygon count in the blank space next to the current polygon count. Then click the Optimize button. This will adjust the outfit's polygons to align with the target polygon count you specified. Individual optimization for trims is also possible, especially when the trim or button are high poly. For individual trim optimization, select the button or trim that you used in the object browser. After selection, input your target polygon count in the face count under the LOD menu in the property editor. This will optimize the trim's polygons to align with your specified count. You can also use trim billboarding to minimize the trim mesh count. Simply enter the number 2 in the face count, or check plane option. The trim will be converted into an image. Please open the completed outfit project after simulation and production. If you prefer to proceed with quad mesh, please use auto retopology feature. Select all patterns and choose optimize quad option under the mesh menu in the property editor. In this tutorial, we will proceed with the triangular mesh. We are going to use Everywhere's polygon optimization to adjust the total polygon count of the outfit. For this tutorial, we will set the target polygon count of the outfit to 12,000. Rigging. Rigging is part of a 3D process of creating a skeleton structure out of joints for the 3D model, which allows users to animate. Everywhere's rigging merges the outfit with the avatar's joints, allowing them to move together. This rigging process also involves weight painting, which determines how much each part of the outfit is influenced by the movement of the avatar's joints. This rigging process involves setting up and creating the controllable structure for the movement of the avatar and the outfit. Clo and Marvelous Designer excel in creating highly detailed and realistic clothing animations through specialized garment simulations. However, due to the large data sizes resulting from simulation-based clothing animations, they are impractical for use in games. In the gaming industry, a different optimization approach, known as rigging, is utilized to synchronize the movement of the outfit and avatar. Everywhere's rigging is designed to synchronize the movements of the garment and avatar for optimal performance. Everywhere's rigging puts the clothing based on the rigging information of the avatar. The avatar should have joints in a human-like form, and rigging only works when the avatar is in an A or T pose. By clicking Rigging Apply in the Garment tab, you can automatically rig the outfit and can see the update and brush tools revealed. Once the auto rigging is complete, you'll notice that weights are applied to the outfit. This means that when you change poses, the outfit will move along with the avatar. When you simulate the rigged outfit, a warning message will appear. If you choose yes, the simulation will run, but all the rigging information will be deleted at the same time. If you choose no, the simulation will not proceed and the rigging information will be retained. If you click the update button, the outfit will be rigged again based on the current state. When clicking the brush tool, the everywhere window will close briefly, and the brush tool will show up at the top right corner of 3D window. In this step, we will use the weight brush to modify weight. This weight painting distributes the weight values to ensure that the rigged outfit moves seamlessly with the avatar's motions. Weight painting adjusts how much influence each joint has on the surrounding vertices. It ensures that movements appear natural and fluid. Although everywhere automatically distributes weights referring to the avatar, it is essential to check for any areas where the outfit may penetrate or not conform accurately to the avatar's motion. If necessary, please make weight adjustments. The weight brush offers three blend modes: add, subtract, and smooth. You can switch between blend modes by pressing the Control Tab key. Add increases the weight, subtract decreases the weight, and smooth brush averages the weights of vertices with those of neighboring vertices, effectively smoothing out the weight distribution. You can adjust the strength, size, focal, and depth of the brush in the brush properties. Hold Alt and square brackets. You can adjust the strength that determines the intensity of the brush. Hold square brackets. You can adjust the brush size. Focal determines the intensity difference between the brush's center and edges, while depth signifies the depth of the brush's influence. Click the Reset button to reset the brush properties to their default values. Press the Exit button to close the brush tool and return to the Everywhere window. Let's see how to modify the weight with the weight brush. Hold Control and click on a joint, which allows you to inspect the weights associated with the joint in the 3D view. The colors are represented in order of red, green, and blue. The red areas indicate a higher weight distribution, while the blue areas indicate a lower weight distribution. The regions without color have a weight value of zero. You can use these brushes to add, subtract, or smooth weight values. Furthermore, you can also apply brushes in the 2D pattern window. Manually move the joints in X-ray joint mode by pressing Shift X, or apply preset poses to check any areas that penetrate or do not follow along with the avatar's motion correctly. If there are areas requiring adjustment, please fix the incorrect weights by changing the blend mode and brush properties. When you notice a specific vertex significantly differs from its surroundings, you can use the hammering function to automatically align it with surrounding values. While holding Shift, the cursor changes from a brush shape to a red dot, allowing recognition of vertices. Keep holding down Shift and click on the spiked vertex to apply hammering. This feature is very useful to address spiked vertices or specific areas such as armpits, the bottom of pants, sleeves, and other regions that may be affected by unwanted joints. When you want to target only specific areas during weight adjustment, the joint lock feature comes in handy. This feature is very helpful, not only in resolving unintended joint influences, but also in achieving precise weight adjustments for a complex outfit. Simply hold down Alt and click on a joint to lock it. Once the joint is locked, it will be highlighted in red. If you want to lock all joints at once, hold Alt and right-click on any joint. To unlock a joint, hold down Alt and click on the lock joint. If you want to unlock all joints at once, hold Alt and right-click on any joint. Now, let's explore the sculpt brush. Press Control and apostrophe key, and you will be able to switch between different brush modes. If you notice that your outfit has holes or overlaps, the Sculpt Brush can help you adjust its shape. The Sculpt Brush offers two blend modes, Grab and Smooth. You can toggle between these modes simply by pressing the Control tab. In Grab mode, you can effectively move the surface of the garment that may be penetrating the avatar or adjust layers that overlap. Use the Grab Brush by clicking and dragging over the surface. The selected area will move in response to your mouse movements. Importantly, the weight will remain unaffected during this process. Smooth mode is handy when you need to even out the garment's surface or soften sharp edges. To apply this, click and drag over the desired area, and the surface will be smooth to blend with its surroundings. Just like the weight brush, you have the flexibility to adjust the strength, size, focal, and depth of the Sculpt Brush according to your preferences. Please address any incorrect regions in the outfit by changing the avatar poses. Utilize the Weight Brush and Sculpt Brush we've covered to correct any issues. Once the rigging process is complete, press the exit button to return to the Everywhere window. UV packing. Let's navigate to the Material tab. UV packing is the feature that automatically lays out UVs without overlapping, allowing you to organize many UVs at once. UV packing is essential to optimize texture resolution and not waste UV space. First, let's go to Everywhere's UV packing and set the UV image size and seam size that determines the spacing value between UV shells. Click the Pack UVs to close the Everywhere window and see the detailed settings of UV packing. The UV editor window will also pop up. In the UV packing window, you can configure and apply related options. The packing ratio represents the allowable error in height and width ratio for automatically placing UVs. The default value is set to 95, and you can fine-tune it within the range of 80 to 100. A value closer to 100 aims to position UVs as close to a perfect square as possible, though it may increase the packing time. Enabling rotation allows for the rotation of UVs, while enabling fixed scale ratio maintains the ratio between UVs while adjusting their overall size. When 0 to 1 is selected in the UV area, the selected UVs are positioned on tile 00. Alternatively, using selected tile allows you to place the selected UVs on the specified tile. Click the Reset button to reset all option settings. Click Apply button to pack the UVs according to the specified options. After configuring the options, click Apply to pack the entire UV. If you need to utilize multiple UV tiles based on the garment and purpose, you can select the desired pattern in the UV editor and click Apply for individual packing. Once the UV packing is complete, press the exit button to return to the Everywhere window. Texture baking. Texture baking is the feature that generates maps to represent the details of a high-poly model on an optimized model. The use of low-poly models and texture baking is essential, because the low-poly models have smaller data sizes than the high-poly models, providing an advantage in optimization. This is particularly beneficial since game engines, AR, and other platforms often face challenges when calculating high-poly models. By using Everywhere's texture baking, without creating a separate high-poly model, only a low-poly model is needed to generate normal maps and ambient occlusion maps. A normal map is a type of texture map commonly used in real-time rendering for games and other interactive platforms to represent high-resolution surface details on a low-resolution model without increasing polygon counts. An ambient occlusion map is a grayscale texture used in rendering to replicate indirect shadows by tracing rays from each surface on a 3D model. Darker areas represent less illuminated regions, while brighter areas indicate well-lit surfaces. This texture map enhances realism by approximating self-shadowing and imitating the effects of indirect light from the environment. In the Everywhere's texture baking window, check detail normal map and ambient occlusion map. The ray sample count for the AO map is the number of rays sampled per pixel. A higher count yields higher quality results, but increases processing time. Click the Apply button to generate the maps. Click on the preview to check the baked map in the 3D window. You can adjust the intensity of the normal map using the slider. The default is 100, and you can set it between 0 and a maximum of 200. Click the trash can icon to delete the map. Material. You can copy or create new materials in the material list and simply apply them to the selected patterns. Initially, materials are generated based on the number of UV tiles, and you can right-click on a material in the list to rename or delete it. Click the Add button to create a new material. Click the Copy button to duplicate the selected material. Click the Assign button to apply the generated material to patterns. The Delete button enables you to remove a material. Please note that the Delete button only works when the material is not assigned to any patterns. Upload. After completing all the tasks, we will now proceed to upload the file. Click the Upload button at the bottom of the Everywhere window. The Options window will appear, and the default settings are as follows. If you have specific preferences, adjust the options and click OK. You will be directed to the Connect Upload webpage. Once the 3D viewer conversion is complete on the item page, click the FBX download button to download the Garmin FBX file. You can also check the converted garment in the Everywhere tab on your Connect portfolio page. You can download the zip project and FBX files from the Items menu button. If the upload conditions are not valid, the following alert items will be displayed. Save as zip project. Once all your tasks are complete, please close the Everywhere window. When you save the project in zip project format, the zip project will store all the adjustments and details made within the Everywhere.